Starfleet Underground. Every week, we'll take a look at the latest Star Trek news and then check out a current or classic episode of Star Trek. On this special teaser, Riker Googles, consoles explode, and what do you get a Borg for Christmas?
Hey, I still can't get this replicator to work. I want my oatmeal.
Love a good oatmeal.
Yes. If you're getting ready for breakfast, I'd recommend the Captain Picard cereal. All the replicated sugar you need to start the day.
Woo.
Heather, do you have anything new?
Yeah. So with my life, it is the Christmas season, which means Christmas cards. And I have been doing over 100 Christmas cards. I'm trying to get them done before Christmas comes here. And my hand, I wish I had a Borg hand. That's all I'm saying. If I had a Borg hand, things would be so much easier.
You know, if we had a bunch of Borg, we could just have each Borg do one or two cards and you'd be done in no time.
So wait, the Borg, it's the collective. So wouldn't that just be one card? Because it's like from one Borg, one collective.
They already have all the cards assimilated. They don't really need more.
Oh, okay. But when you're getting a Borg a Christmas gift and you have multiple Borg, do you get them one gift?
Christmas is irrelevant. Oh, you will be assimilated.
That's right.
Well, I guess their card would basically say happy assimilation.
Your jolliness will be assimilated.
Good tidings to you. You will be assimilated.
That's awesome.
Merry Borgmas.
Rocky, got anything new you want to talk about?
Well, I've been just fascinated lately going through Twitter because I've been discovering all these wonderful Star Trek Twitter handles out there at Riker Googling. It's just been hilarious, the stuff that Riker's been Googling lately, because we had that whole Peloton thing and lo and behold, Riker was Googling Peloton.
The image I got when you say what he's Googling, the images that came up in my head, all of the porn sites and everything, not a good idea.
There was a comment about sending dick pics and erasing them from the computer logs. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, you got to watch out for Riker Googling. And then, of course, there's Annoyed O'Brien, which is understandable.
Oh, I love that.
And one of my favorites that I just like, is classic, is Exploding Console. It's at Boom Console. And it's just a freeze frame of whenever the consoles explode on the bridge. And then, of course, there was a replicator unit, Starfleet replicator, which was, it's always got a comment about something nutritious.
You know, a replicator would make a perfect present.
Bypass the whole microwave and food processing thing right away. It's like the ultimate food processor, the replicator.
I wonder how much a replicator would cost.
$19,999,995.
It'll be developed by like Amazon. Amazon replicators. Guaranteed delivery in 1 minute or less.
It's basically Amazon is the replicator.
Guaranteed to listen to you 24 hours a day.
Seriously.
It also act as a kitchen timer.
Let's just hope the Ferengi don't acquire that company. Then the price would be through the roof.
They would make profits, mass profits.
I mean, that's been a long-standing gag with the exploding panels because a lot of people have commented, you know, like, why do panels always explode?
Yeah, you think about it. You look at today's technology. It's like it's just a flat screen. You know, iPads don't explode. They just kind of crash. They don't.
Right. They would turn off.
It doesn't like shoot sparks in your face when you crash a browser. Yeah.
To fly my nerd hat for a moment, I did research on that because that annoyed me. As it turns out, if you know you have the EPS conduits, it's not actually the panel exploding. It's the plasma feed that's inside of it. So when the plasma gets traumatized or falls off the circuit, the resulting thing is that is the plasma. That's why. Anytime somebody's near explained, they got the nasty, horrible burns that they got to send the doc for. It's all due to plasma.
That is just so freaking cool. You look that up and know that.
Yeah, so taking off nerd hat.
That is so cool.
I guess circuit breakers don't apply as easily to plasma conduits as they do for modern day electronics. So got to be careful. It's a very good way to get power, but oh boy, don't short it out.
That is interesting. Although if one would think control panels, you know, using today's analogy, are typically, you know, low voltage, low current type circuits. You know, it's not your main heavy duty power circuits.
But like you would need heavy duty power circuits in order to do the warp drive.
Warp drive, yes, but the control panels, no.
It's like having seatbelts on the bridge. Why doesn't anybody have a damn seatbelt?
Lost technologies.
Airbags.
Well, let's face it. I think it all comes down to dramatic liberty.
Yep.
Starfleet Underground, beaming in January 2020 to a podcast feed near you. Lock on to our website at starfleetunderground.com and send your comments and questions to thecollective@starfleetunderground.com. Follow us on Twitter at StarfleetUnderG and on Facebook and Instagram, we're Starfleet Underground.
And then just remember one thing. Don't just have a nice week. Make it so. This was Starfleet Underground.